You should have come with me. It was nice, you know? At least you should have come with me once. Don't tell me you're still in bed. Do you want me to come and wake you up?
You've always been there for me when I needed you. You made my life worth living. Ever since that day, my mind has always been broken. Sometimes I wish he had just killed me. I feel bad telling you this because you are the only joy in my life. But that's how I feel sometimes. Angelica.
What's the meaning of this? Who's he? Angelica, where are you now?
Pay close attention to my words. There's an island floating in the sky, and on this island you will find your doom. The towering building that pierces the sky, the place where this story began. However, if you want to enter, you'll have to play my game. They say home is where the heart is, and it is true. That house is dark and decaying. I wonder if her heart is too. Maybe you don't have much time. She had a big treasure, but now it's lost. Part of the treasure is up in the mountains of sand. The other part? I don't know, but shouldn't be hard to find. Just ask the doctor. When we want to forget something, what do? We bury it very deep. My dark secret is underground, and that's where you'll have to go to. To open the way, you need the key to my heart.
You came looking for her. You think you can save her. I dare you to come and find her. She is locked in the tower. I'm waiting for you. I'll put my knife inside you, and then I'll break you.
Thank you.
yesterday, when I went to get some milk and bread, I met a boy. He had a pretty smile and small eyes. When we shook hands, he was surprised that I gave him my left hand, but he told me I was very pretty, and I know my face turned red when he said that. I was so nervous. I even forgot to ask his name.
It wasn't my fault. It was not. We were arguing, that's all. And then she fell down the stairs and died. The device is finished. I want to feel safe, so I will lock myself in the room every night. I can unlock the door from the inside just fine, but anyone on the other side will need to use the new machine to unlock it. Today, I finally got the two-button configuration to work. The left button rotates the left plate 45 degrees and the right one 90 degrees clockwise. The other button rotates them 60 and 30 degrees counterclockwise. I will carry this combination with me at all times. And I can't even sleep well. I hear him walking around all night. I don't even know if my mind is playing tricks on me. I don't know if I'm going insane. I'm afraid to be alone. I'm afraid to close my eyes. I don't want to go through that nightmare again. My head started pounding last time I went down there. After a while, I began to hear a voice inside my head, and my body felt different. I spent a long time staring at my hand. I knew it was my hand, but I couldn't recognize it. I don't want to go down there again. I don't know why, but that place makes me feel uneasy.
Caleb and I have been friends for about 6 months. He's a nice guy. He doesn't seem to care about, well, you know, my problem. He says I'm perfect the way I am. He's 19, and he doesn't care that I'm 14. I know it sounds like a huge difference now, but I don't think it will be a big problem when we grow up. We're going to the lake this weekend, and I hope he'll finally kiss me today. So excited. He finally did! He put his hands on my cheeks and kissed me. Oh, I was like, oh my God, he's finally kissing me. It was so, I don't know, I'm sure I'm just turning red again and again. Oh, best birthday gift ever. Studying Dad's notes, I made my own design, and it works very well. I may have my mother's eyes, but definitely I have my father's brains. I added a second button to his original design. Each button rotates the corresponding piece 90 degrees. Tomorrow I will try another configuration, so I can rotate both pieces with one button. Oh, I have to finish it soon. I feel so insecure in this place. I have the feeling someone is watching me. I'd wish my mom was more supportive about this thing with Caleb. At least she should pretend to be happy about me meeting him. Ugh, I am still so mad for what she said to me yesterday. You know, it's not my fault that she's unhappy all the time.
My gift was a red rose. Red is the color of love. He made me a crown. It was golden, just like my hair. That same day, he kissed my lips and gave me his ring. Do you know what it is to feel special? Do you know what that meant to me? Do you know how it felt to be loved for what I was? He wanted the real me. You wanted a porcelain doll. Freya, all I ever wanted was for you to be there for me. I don't even want you to love me. I just want you to accept me.
I met two of Caleb's friends yesterday. I didn't like them. They were so dumb, making fun of him because I'm so young. Why should they care that I am young? Caleb likes me anyway, and I'm glad that they didn't know about my problem, or else things would have been worse. He told them to leave. And when we were alone, he put his hands on my shoulders and pressed his forehead against mine. He can make my pain go away so easily. It's like magic. I told Caleb that my mother's dead. I don't know how I feel right now. I guess I feel alone and sad and... But I still feel all this hatred for her inside of me. I can't forgive her for what she did and said all those years. I don't know. But I can't say that I won't miss her. I feel completely alone. If only my dad was here.
Thank you.
There was a young, sweet girl. She had white skin, golden hair, and an angelic face. One day, she met three monsters. Do you know what happened to her? Do you know what they did? I know. She told me. Part of me died the day that she told me. Part of me wanted revenge. Do you know who I'm talking about? Your dear girlfriend. Do you know why she has nightmares all the time? Do you know why she wakes up screaming and crying? She's never told you what happened, right? Maybe she doesn't trust you. Maybe she knows you can't help her. One of the monsters is in the next room, trapped inside a machine. I put him there. That's his punishment for what he did. What would you do if you met one of the monsters? Would you kill the monster? Would you become a monster yourself?
I come looking for him and his infinite glory. I sit to his right, for with his right hand he measures my deeds. Not in first line, because that's where the hypocrites belong. Not on the back, because I may not see you. A few are behind me, some to my right, but no one in front of me can obscure your glory. I don't come empty-handed. I give you everything that I am. I know we all have a purpose. So I have to ask, what's my purpose? Is there a reason why I was born like this? Why I was born so weak? Sometimes I still hate myself. This body, it... I had a dream the other day. I was a little kid. And the other kids would get scared when looking at me. Older kids would simply laugh. And that made me feel so bad. I wanted to run away and hide for all eternity. Then, when I was hiding and crying, I heard a man's voice telling me I was special. And that I was meant to do great things. Then I woke up. I knew it was a dream. I knew it was a dream, but it felt so real.
The first one was a grown man. He was a teacher at some sort of university. He liked biology. That doesn't sound so bad, but what comes next will make you change your mind. He was very fond of young girls. Very young girls. I don't want to remember what he did to them, because it gives me nightmares for days. Richard was his name, but I can't remember his last name. Yesterday, I had a dream. I was maybe 7 years old, and I was at a church. There was a man with me. He had a kind voice, but I couldn't see his face. He said he'd always be with me when I needed him, and that one day, I'd bring justice to this world. What does that even mean? Sometimes I have weird dreams like that one. I share these dreams with my angel. And she said that maybe the man in my dream was my dad. Much of my past is just a fog. Who needs a past anyway? I am only interested in one thing. My present. Why are you following me? Why are you even here? Are you here because you love her? Does that even exist? I pity you. That love you think you feel is not real. Her love for you is not real. Welcome to my game. Welcome to my world. Now, you'll see everything through my eyes. There is a place where we all hide our darkest sides. You already know I have nothing to hide from you, so I'm leaving the key for you. Use it whenever you want. Sometimes I have weird dreams. I dreamt about a girl and a woman arguing. I then see the woman falling down some stairs. She reaches the bottom, but her body is bent in a very unnatural way. Sometimes I also dream about three men, or rather, shadows that look like men. I see a man with a knife on his chest, choking in his own blood, and a young girl, naked and covered in blood, crying. Do you care for her? I mean, do you really care for her? You don't know what happened to her, but can you guess it? Do you know how it feels to know you can't help the one you love? Do you know how it feels to know no matter what you do, you can't fix her because you can't change the past? When she told me what happened, I went to look for the monsters. I wanted revenge. I found one of them, and don't ask me what I did. The worst part was realizing no matter what I did, I could not fix her. I could not change her past. I don't expect you to understand. In a way, I know you will never understand.
After the incident with that boy, Dr. Hello locked me inside one of his cells. It was completely dark, save for the faint light that came in from above the door. That faint light gave me hope. But it also drove me insane because it reminded me that the light was so close. The nurse didn't even let me out when I told her that I needed to go. She just told me to squat in the corner. She just told me to squat in the corner and get it over with. Dr. Aro kept me here for 2 entire weeks. That's 14 days. That's 336 hours. 336 damn hours of torment and despair.
Congratulations. Don't feel so good about yourself, though.
This one was easy.
I'm not strong enough to kill a monster with my own hands, but I am good at building things. So I decided to use machines to put them through tests. Maybe I am not strong enough, but I am smart enough. Smarter than most. After a couple of times, do you know what I realized? Tests give monsters hope. Hope that they can get out if they're smart enough. Hope that there's a small chance that they will survive. Congratulations. Don't feel so good about yourself, though. This one was easy.
I'm the only one Mary is getting in bed with. Maybe she needs a friend or something and thinks she can trust me because of my angel face. She keeps asking me about my life. I have no idea what these whores have in their heads. I didn't come to talk, and she should know that. She may have a pretty face and a friendly personality, but she isn't different from those women walking down the street half-naked begging for it. I really hate those women.
Welcome. You can't hide. I can see you. I'm coming for you, so you better run! Thank you. I'm coming for you, so you better run! If she dies, you have to go through this door. If you save her, congratulations.
There was a young, sweet girl.
She had white skin, golden hair, and an angelic face. One day she met three monsters. One of them was named Jack. Everything I know about pain, I learned from him.
Did you really think, for one second, that I'd give you the right answer?
Don't trust anyone.
I'm coming for you, so you better run!
Did you really think, for one second, that I'd give you the right answer? Don't trust anyone.
Coming for you, so you better run!
Hit her hard, cut her until she bleeds, and ram the knife in her chest. Make her bleed. Make her cry. Make her suffer. Make her beg. When she can't take it anymore, release her. Show her the open door and let her crawl to it. Let her think she can save herself. And when she can feel the fresh air, thinking she can escape, grab her legs and drag her back in for more. Destroy that whore. She deserves it.